Here in Whitehead this morning, and welcome if you're joining us online. Lovely to have all of you here. Lovely to see you. Lovely to join together on such a beautiful, beautiful morning. It looks like it's going to be packed down on the path later on. I would say it'll be busy, but just remember, be careful while you're down there if you're planning on heading out for a walk. Be a beautiful day for it. Maybe you'll get to sit out in your garden. But it is good to be together here to worship Jesus Christ, here with our brothers and sisters in Christ, to join voice and heart together and lift up the name of Jesus Christ. I want to read a little bit for you this morning. Seemed like a wonderful day to read a wonderful psalm. We'll read Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, Lord, you are our good shepherd. In your goodness, you supply our every need. You are our shepherd pastor, and you take care of us. You are the good shepherd. We thank you, Lord, that you lead us into safety, that you give us strength for the journey. We thank you that you grant us rest and restore our souls. We praise you that you are the good shepherd. We thank you that you sought us out when we were lost, called us by our name. We thank you that you are our shepherd. And you are carrying us home. In Jesus' name we pray, Lord. Amen. I'm going to join heart and voice, and we're going to sing together. As usual at the moment, I have to advise you to sing softly. Sing softly and well. But we're going to sing Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. Let's worship God together.
Oh,
Chapters in those two books are very directly and very clearly connected. I thought just to make things a little easier for us and to give us a little bit of joy, we'll watch a little animated version of what happened. This is the story of Joshua.
The Faithful Hall of Fame, Joshua. This is Joshua. Joshua was an Israelite who followed Moses through the wilderness. Joshua learned from Moses as Moses led the Israelites through the Red Sea. And as Moses taught the people about God's law.
Listen up.
One day, Moses was talking to the Israelites. He was reminding them of the law and all that God had done for them. When Moses had finished giving instructions to the people, he said, "I am no longer able to lead you."
Hold on.
"Do not be afraid, for God will neither fail you nor abandon you."
Yeah.
Then Moses called Joshua and told him to be strong and courageous, for he would lead the Israelites into the promised land.
See?
Then Moses died. To this day, no one knows exactly where he was buried. The people and all of Israel mourn. The people of Israel looked to Joshua to lead them, as Moses had told them.
There he is.
Yeah.
God told Joshua to be strong and courageous, for he would be with Joshua wherever he went. He told him to remember what Moses had told him and to study the book of instruction. God told Joshua that it was time to lead the people of Israel across the Jordan River and into the Promised Land.
Okay, here we are.
Joshua told the Israelite officials to go throughout the camp.
Yeah, there.
They instructed everyone to pack up and get ready to head out.
Come on.
Joshua told the Israelites they were going to cross the Jordan River.
See here, that's what we're gonna do, okay?
And so, Joshua prepared to lead his people as the Lord had commanded.
A difficult moment for the children of Israel. They had been they'd been familiar with Moses. They had gone forward with him. They had come through so much together, crossing the Red Sea, leaving Egypt, going through the wilderness and all the challenges and difficulties of that. And it must have been a difficult moment for them to get to that point where Moses said, "It's time for me to go." And then we have Joshua. Joshua, who, like a lot of those leaders in the Old Testament, whenever he arrives, he felt incredibly weak and incapable, and he needed to hear that word from God: "Be strong and courageous, for I will be with you." We're going to continue in our worship. We're going to sing a song that picks up on those words: "Be strong and courageous." Let's stand, let's sing together. Do sing, albeit softly, and let's worship God. "Be strong and courageous, do not be afraid." One of those songs, it's always quite good to have a hurdle through a song every now and again. So much joy, but good words to sing. Be strong and courageous, for the Lord your God will be with you. And then, just to give you a little advance notice and a warm invitation, we're looking forward on the 20th of June to sharing together around the Lord's table. We haven't been able to have a service of communion for over 14 months, and it would be lovely to take time to share with one another around the Lord's table once more. It'll be a little bit different to normal. We'll be using little pre-packed communion cups, they look a bit peculiar, but they do a really good job. They have both the wine and the bread, not mixed up, but they have the wine and the bread in it. You peel off the little bit at the top and you get the little bit of bread, and then you peel off the next layer and you're able to drink the wine. And you'll collect those as you arrive in church. And then you'll just leave them behind at your seat and we'll collect them up afterwards. Okay, so very simple and straightforward. Also, you don't have to be a communicant member to come on that day. You don't even have to be a communicant member to take communion. All you need is to be someone of faith, someone who puts their hope and their trust in Jesus Christ as their Saviour and Lord. And there will be a place for you at his table. And so that's on the 20th of June. You'll see a little notice on the screen just to remind you of that. Let me see. Now, let's turn to God in prayer. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, Lord, we want to thank you. We want to thank you for a firm foundation. We want to thank you for the solid ground beneath our feet. The solid ground of your promises. We want to thank you for this rock. For this rock upon which we stand. Built up layer by layer from the beginning of time. Thank you, Lord, for the rocks of this world even that tower over us. Mountains that provide us with a long distant view. But most of all, we thank you that you are our rock. You're solid and reliable and eternal. And with you as our foundation, as our cornerstone, we can weather any storm. So today, Lord, we come to you. We come with requests for all of those known to us, even those among us, who even now feel that their earth is shaking. Pray for people whose lives have been turned upside down through grief and loss and illness. And we take a moment, Lord, just to bring all those known to us, our family and our friends, who are struggling right now, whether through the ravages of COVID, or whether perhaps through cancer, or through some other long-term illness. Lord, we ask that you would gather all of these into your arms, that you would bless them, that you would heal them, that you would restore them. Hold us fast, we pray. Keep our feet steady. We confess all too often we have been very quick to build on sand. Instead of loving the people in our community, we are far too easily given to judgment. Instead of helping those in need, we often prefer to walk by. Thank you that in your grace and mercy you forgive us. You give us strength to make better choices. Lord, we know there are many countries around the world where the basic building blocks of a safe society are threatened. We pray especially today for countries such as the Yemen and Afghanistan and Somalia and Ethiopia, where armies are busy at war. And where the weak, the frail, the vulnerable, the fragile are so often caught in the jaws. We pray, Lord, for those caught up in such conflicts, where there are so many warlords trying to cut out their piece of the pie, trying to make gains out of this moment of terrible weakness. We pray, Lord, for a resurgence of good government, government that seeks to protect the weak, that seeks to stand in defense of those who are not able to stand for themselves, that seeks to provide protection of human rights, especially for the vulnerable, for the elderly, for children, for women, for all those who are easy targets. We pray, Lord, that your hand would surround them. We pray, Lord, for all those charity organizations that are operating in those places, and even those that are operating here at home, to bring protection. We pray, Lord, that you would prosper their work, that you might preserve them from harm. God, you are our hope. We pray your help for our little community of faith here. Lord, you know we want to be faithful. We want to be sharing your good news. So, Lord, help us to build on the solid foundation of Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. We're going to stand and sing once more. We're going to sing, "Great is thy faithfulness." Let's worship God together. Of Joshua. So I'm going to begin reading at verse 1. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord. The Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I am about to give to them, to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon, and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country, to the great sea in the west. No one will be able to stand up against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their forefathers to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen. May the Lord bless the reading of his word to us this morning. I want to say something a bit personal this morning. It's something, well, I think maybe some of you may have seen it coming. Many of you will know that June and I have been far from comfortable with the current direction that the Presbyterian Church seems to be going in. We have found it painful and hard. It seems to be, in our view, to our mind, it seems to be excluding people that we would like to welcome. And over the last couple of years, we have tried to the best of our ability to continue to minister. These years that we have spent here in Whitehead, they really have been some of our, well, the very best years of our lives. We have felt incredibly blessed, incredibly content and happy. We have come to know and love each and every one of you. But the time has come when we're going to have to leave. I have a form of words that I have to read out. So let me just read this out. I am informing you that I intend to request the Presbytery of Carrickfergus to release me from my charge as Minister of Whitehead on the 30th of September this year. I wanted to tell you now, because I wanted you to hear from me first and not after I have made the request. I know the way these things go. Sometimes the jungle drums get going and you may, sometimes people find things out, and I don't want you to have to find things out secondhand. I know that we're not all here, and I'm sorry for that. But I just have found it incredibly difficult. Well, many of you know, you've seen how I have been, you know how June has been. June took the decision last October that she didn't feel comfortable coming to a Presbyterian church anymore. Because she felt if it was a church that was saying to anybody that you're not welcome, that you're not invited, on the basis of gender, on the basis of your sexual orientation, that that wasn't the place that she could be. And I've tried to keep going. I really have. But it's become a bit like trying to ride two horses at the same time that are, they're going in two different directions. And I have prayed, and I have read, and I have sought wisdom. And in many ways, I look to the Bible, and I look to those folk in the Old Testament, like Joshua, and like Moses, and I was looking at so many of them, and looking at Gideon and Jeremiah, and David, and looking at all these folk who feel so who are so cold and so. And so powerless and so incapable and so lacking in strength of their own. And I feel that call. It's a call to leave the church of my birth, the church that I've grown up in. My life as a Presbyterian has not just been a life in ministry, it was my life and it has been my life. Since ever I first went to church. And what I hear is God calling me to those who certainly feel cast out, who feel rejected, who feel unloved. And I know many will say they're not unloved, and I understand that. And I know many of you would want to say the same, that they are loved. But the decisions taken by our denomination mean that they can never belong. And that's a hard thing to have to say to anybody. So I hear these words that were spoken to Joshua. And I hear them very personally. I hear them as words of calling. I hear them as God saying, be strong, Ian. Be strong, Judy. Be strong and courageous. Go and look after the lost sheep. Go and look after those who need a shepherd. And we haven't decided. I mean, that makes it sound like we are leaving and going into something that's established and set, but we're not. We have no idea what our next steps are going to be. There is no job plan. There is no firm plan of what waits for us. This is just, we believe that God has just called us to this first step. But I am so, so sorry to be leaving. I think in that sense, I feel a bit like Moses. Moses was an old man at the time that he finished with the children of Israel. But he was an old man in robust good health. An old man who would love to have taken the children of Israel through to the promised land. But who, because of his actions as a younger man, was not allowed to do so. But do not be afraid. Do not be afraid, little flock. Because there will be someone come who will take you on in the journey, who will take you the next step, who will take you to where you need to be. I have no doubt. I just want to, this sounds like I'm saying goodbye today. You will have gathered that obviously I will still be your minister through until the end of September. Part of the reason for that date is that I've been asked to conduct a wedding in September, and I was very delighted to be able to say yes, and I'm very much looking forward to that. But so I will still be serving as your minister, and it will continue to be, as it always has been, the great privilege of my life. You have become to me more than a congregation, more than a church. You have become family. And I hope you know that my love for you and June's love for you has not faded one iota. I thank you for your care for June while she was ill, and the constant inquiries we still get. How's she doing? How's her recovering? I can tell you she's recovering well. I think the greatest thing she's experiencing at the moment is profound frustration, because she'll do something, she'll have a busy day and it might take her 2 days to recover. Or she might have two busy days and it might take her a week. But she's improving. And I appreciate your care, your compassion and your prayers. At the end of the day, we do stand on a firm foundation. It is the firm foundation of Jesus Christ. We stand on grace, not on legalism. We stand and depend on His mercy, each and every one of us. There is not one of us without sin. And not one of us in need of, who is not in need of His grace. So none of us is perfect. And yet, in Jesus Christ, all of us can be made perfect. So be encouraged. Be blessed. I am sorry that I won't be here for the rest of your journey. But I won't be going away. It's a bit like that famous comment, I'll not be too far away, we'll not be any further away than Belfast. These next few months will be a time of some preparation. There will be bits and pieces that we will need to work on together. There will be some technical and practical matters, and there will be some thoughtful process that needs to be done. But I know that the Presbytery of Carrickfergus will look after you well. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you, both now and forevermore. Amen. I'd like to close by singing a beautiful hymn. A hymn that I've really come to love while I've been here. But it seems like a good hymn for this moment. We're going to sing "When Peace Like a River Attendeth My Way." We're going to sing verses 1, 2, and 4. Let's worship God.
Lord, have mercy.
God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all, and those that you love, for today and forever and ever and ever. Amen. Please take your seats.